Hi guys, so lately I received a question on my Facebook page if this tutorial is applicable in Elementor. Actually, this process works in all kind of plugins or all kinds of themes. So whether you're using Elementor, Genesis, or Avada, it really doesn't matter. So regardless of the theme, you can implement on-click pop-up without using a plugin. But since this tutorial, I use DV on my tutorial, most of the screenshots in here are in DV interface. But yeah, I'm going to show you how this works on Elementor if you are using an Elementor plugin. And yeah, so this is the website, and she wants, so currently let me preview that one. So currently, if you click this get free ticket, it just go to a different page, and she want to use an unclick pop-up. Okay, so yeah, let's see how we can implement this one. So let's open the page. The page is called this one, Spirit of Expectancy Registration, and then we need to have, so I'm going to edit it as Elementor. I think she will remove the DV for some reason, because she told me if I can use Elementor for the on-click pop-up, so I assume she will remove the DV, because I highly recommend you only choose one page builder. If you use DV, then stick to DV. If you use Elementor, then stick to Elementor. So you only need to choose one. Okay, first I'm gonna use my documentation as my guidelines. Okay, so first is we need to have an on-click modal or an on-click wrapper for our pop-up. Okay, so we need to have three classes in here. So as you can see, add a code module or an HTML code. So in Elementor, there is an HTML code. You should be able to see that if you search it into your page. Wait a minute. So I think it is here, in here, and you need to type HTML, and you can drag it in any part of the page, but I prefer to put it at the top of the page. So this is an HTML page. Now we need to set three classes, okay, a hierarchy of classes. So div class, pricing background. So pricing background serves to be our overlay, the gray overlay, and then another div class for the pop-up. I remember the name is pricing table. By the way, you can use different kind of class names, but I want to just keep use of these classes, because I put some CSS code in here, and I don't want to, you know, modify it again. So we will just use similar classes. So put it in there, and then another hierarchy of class. I'm gonna call it close pop, I believe. So close pop is the X thing, this one. So if someone click this close icon, then the pop-up will disappear. Okay. And then we need to add another class in here. I'm going to call it C pricing. Okay. C pricing. By the way, I'm going to change this one later. This is outdated. We will put C pricing as a class instead of ID. So that one, and then I will add a X there. So X and then close. X and then close. By the way, you can use font awesome if you want it to be more fancy. So I want just to keep it simple as possible for the purpose of this presentation. So right now, this is the pop-up. Actually, let's put the iframe. So this is the iframe that she want on the pop-up. So it's a booking form. So it's a booking form update. Let's see. So right now, this is the booking form. Now, we need to add a custom class. This one should be hide. So this will only appear once they click these buttons, okay? So to do that, we need to declare a custom CSS. So I have a code in here, so we will grab this code. Okay, I'm gonna grab this code and just paste it into your custom CSS.
By the way, if you find my video helpful, feel free to subscribe to my channel, click that subscribe button and that like, thumbs up, and the bell notification if you want to receive new videos from me.
So you can also put it into your HTML if you just want to isolate the CSS. I mean, the pop-up will only appear. I mean, this on-click pop-up design will only appear on one specific page. Then you can just put it onto your HTML page. Or I believe there is an option in the Elementor, but I think she's using a free version. So this custom CSS is not available for free version. So, or, but I'm just confused with her themes right now because she is using Divi as her themes and then an Elementor as her plugin. So whether you're using Avada, you just need Avada, Genesis, any kind of themes, you just need to look for the options where you can add your custom CSS. So you put this code in here to the custom CSS, but if you're not using Divi, again, look for an option in your themes where you can put your custom CSS. I believe all of the themes has this option, so I think this is located in the appearance and then customize. Okay, and then for the JavaScript or the jQuery, you need it to put on the options where you can add a script section or a JavaScript section. This is again located into the customizer, or you can also install a plugin called, I think it's called Custom CSS and JavaScript. Let's try. So this one, you can also use this one and put the code for the custom CSS and JavaScript. But I believe this is not necessary because most of the themes has an options for you to add your jQuery and your custom CSS. Now we need a trigger. So I'm gonna go to my button in here. Okay, go to the advanced, and then we will declare a class called cPricing. So this will tie it up to our on-click pop-up. So once the cPricing is clicked, then the on-click pop-up will appear. So that's how it looks. But in order for us to make that working, we need to have a JavaScript or a jQuery. So this jQuery, okay, should be added into your custom JavaScript code. So in Divi, it is located in general and then integration, and then you put it here. Again, the code in here, like I made some changes, but the code are all added in here. So you just need to copy all the codes here and here. And I will update this as well to make it so you can just copy the code instead of typing it to avoid some mistakes. So I'm gonna update this one as well. So I'll try to update this page and make it a tutorial not only for DV but at the same time for the Elementor as well. So just look for the description on my video for more information. Okay, and then let's try to click this one. Okay, and then close. Click, close, click, close. And that's it. I hope you find it helpful. Feel free to subscribe to my channel if you want to receive more videos from me. And comment down below or send me a message on Facebook what topic you want me to cover in my next video. I'm always reading all of your comments and I really appreciate it. Thank you so much again and have a great day. Thank you.
Yeah.